Your father was a former senator.
Yes.
Your grandfather was a former senator.
Yes.
You are third generation. Can you tell me what's the pressure like? I can only imagine. I mean, you have Sonny Angara following in his father's footsteps, other second generation, mm-hmm. you have JV Jingoy, their father was president.
Mm-hmm.
You're in the same shoes. How hard is it?
Well, people expect a lot of you. People expect that the tradition of what a Tañada is, straight shooter, good governance, would always be there.
No.
But of course, there has been a gap. And we have admitted this. As a matter of fact, when I was talking to my father, he was asking me, why run in 2019, not in 2022?
Your father could have wisdom there.
Yes.
A midterm elections, an extremely popular president. I mean, you have Duterte hitting 70-80%. So
yes.
It is his time. Why run now?
Well, if you look at it, I was kidding my father. I told him, Tay, the people who recognize our name are senior citizens. If I wait another 3 years, you may not be able to vote for me. And he was laughing and he said, you're correct. The people who know us are above 60 years old or maybe even 55.
Because they remember him.
They remember him. They remember my grandfather when my grandfather was marching the streets during the martial law years, during the Marcos years, at 86 years old, being tear gassed and water cannoned. So there's that connection still, but in a older generation. So the challenge here now is trying to introduce Tañada to the younger generation.
And how are you doing it? I wanted to ask you that.
Well, again, we're doing the usual social media, going to schools.
Yeah.
We have Youth for Erin volunteers. And what is interesting, when you go down to the communities and you mention Tañada, immediately they say, ano mo si Tañada? So the awareness is there.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of informing them that there's a Tañada that's running.
Okay.